at the recording studio, and I don't like what I'm seeing right now, to be honest. What are you two doing together?
Yes.
All right, let's take you from the top. Ready?
Okay.
Go for it. The scenery around me is glowing. Can't keep control of where I'm going. Sorry, can we start again? What's the matter? I don't know. I just feel like that was my best take. I think I'm off my game today. I could do this just fine in practice. Yeah, I think I see what the problem is. You're wearing too many layers of clothing, I think. As with this one guy as the generator is me. It's the audio coach, like the vocal sound studio engineer, beanie guy. When you're singing into the microphone, you look really stiff. You need to loosen up a little. God, what is it gonna do with her? Feel free to move around a little. Bounce on your toes. Bob your head. I don't even need to make a joke, do I? Get a feel for the room. Is it okay for me to bob my head? Can they stop saying this? If I'm constantly changing the distance between my mouth and the microphone, won't it come out sounding weird? We can equalize that later on, can't we? Don't worry about that. Things like that are easy for me to fix. What matters most is having you bring the right energy to this performance. Loosen up. Feel free to move your feet or do whatever. What is this guy? He's like a younger version of me. Or whatever else it takes to get in the same mindset that you have when performing on stage. Alright, let's try again. The scenery around me is glowing. Can't keep control of where... Sorry, I think I'm just a little off today.
Okay.
Alright, let's try this. I'm going to pipe in some crowd noise from the last concert. Can you hear the crowd? Throw your panties! Yeah, I can hear them.
Yes.
If you want to, close your eyes. Remember what it was like being on stage? The audience doesn't care about how clean and polished you are. They care about how enthusiastic and passionate you are. The fans can tell when you're enjoying yourself. This is weird. You're not singing for the microphone, you're singing for them. Okay, I think I'm ready. Tanaka Sara sings the verse with deep and full-throated passion. Oh, I love myself some full-throated passion. With each phrase, she leans forward, rocking on her feet in time with the rhythm of the song. That was great! That's the take that we're looking for.
Yatta!
Yeah, that felt good. Sorry, I forgot my water bottle back in the break room. Can I run out real quick just to grab a drink? Yeah, no problem. Thanks, I'll be right back. As Tanaka Sara leaves, Shinzawa Yoshitaro turns and notices you. Oh, hey, Mr. Delta, didn't notice you coming in. That was great! Are you sure that you can get good recordings like that? I hear you. I thought the same thing a lot of times. Should I aim for a more polished performance or a more passionate one? For a lot of my career, I thought so much about finding the balance between polish and passion. I wonder what triggered this event. Do people prefer crisp, clean vocals, or would they rather have raw passion? But the thing I've come to realize more and more is that making the track sound polished is my job. If the performer can bring the right energy to the booth, then I can make it sound as clean as it needs to be for the track. Of course, it's not easy. Everyone requires a different amount of fine-tuning. But I think I've got to the point where no matter what track I'm working on, I can find the best version of the singer's voice for that track. Don't start slacking. Keep up the good work. If you're really that amazing at your job, then like you deserve yourself like an idol treat every once in a while. I can leave you some scraps if you want. I appreciate it, boss. I'm back.
Yes.
Oh, hey, time to get back to business. Shinzawa Yoshitaro production level increased. Nice, why can't these events happen sooner? Hey, hello.
Hello.
This was unplanned. I was trying to wait until we can release the next single. Alas, it looks like the episode is gonna start like this. And we're gonna have to wait one more day, then we can release this. Gonna take a new loan and do the auditions today. That's right. Come on. Yeah, that's good enough for me. And with the new girls, maybe we find some new pleasure, some new ideas, some fresh energy to go about this more successfully than before. I don't know. Maybe it's the number of guilds that just pumps my stats full of vigor. I don't know. See how much we sold. Not quite a new record, but 6.5 million profit, which is what we need really at this point. Some levels. A few more fans. Only 4 idols participated in this single, which is, well, I guess, like, the retiring ones. So we're gonna take the Fujimoto loan to end all loans. We took, like, a 55 million last time for still paying off. Before that, we took a 30 million, then a 25 million before that, and, like, some smaller ones. But what we're gonna do now is gonna be, like, a 70 million loan. That should keep us afloat for a little bit. Oh my god. Yeah, there's not a lot available since I have like several running at once. But due to no interest rate, I might as well take it all out at all times, right? It's like money I get in advance and I just have to pay it back over time. If banks worked like that, I would just take out all of the loans if there was no interest at all. That would be fucking incredible. Is everything alright for Fujimoto 6 months? Here we go. Get a cute advertisement deal? We can do that. Easily, we can do that. What we do now is we're gonna hold an audition. A nationwide one, because that guarantees us a gold idol. One guaranteed gold idol. I wonder if I should run several auditions. I have a penalty for scandal points, which means I won't get any platinum idols from auditions. Let's just hold one. Okay, looks like it takes some time. I need to get rid of some points. It increases my liability, it decreases sales and like the bonus, and it's not good. All good things must come to an end. Flames to dust, lovers to friends. Why do all good things come to an end? And then I feel that my time with Little Abnormalities will be coming to an end on May 12th. This year? Do I have some influence? I guess after all that Little Abnormalities has done for me, I could stick around a bit longer. I'll move my graduation date to August 2025. Yeah, you better. You're gonna stay working for us until you're an old hag, Tanaka-sara. That's right. While we wait for this, I saw that we can create some new dishes. So why not create one based on Tanaka-sara, who will stay with us forever? Oh! It's a shrimp soup surprise. I don't know. Is that shrimp? I can't tell. Really bad with seafood. 100% novelty, I guess, since it's new. Has a male appeal. Why? What did she do with it? We can even do another one. Let's make one based on Matsumura Aura. It's gotta be something angry, something red. It's exactly the same. It's the angry shrimp soup. No surprise. Okay. Is that enough? We can fill out 2 more slots. Okay, on Sundays, that's gonna be, like, the shrimp soup surprise, and on Tuesdays, the no surprise one. Which, again, has a male appeal, but a much lower quality, apparently. We're making some good profit with these. Look at this. Look. And since we're making money with this every single day, would you take a look at that? We're even making some fans every once in a while, apparently. Shall we create one more? Who doesn't have a... You know what, Arcade Arena? You don't have a dish yet. But I'm gonna give one to Abe Mickey instead. Aww. I feel like there's only 3 pictures for these, which means my naming scheme will run into a wall sooner than these idols will. So instead of calling this, like, what did I call this before? The brown chicken gravy soup or something? Instead, I'm gonna call this birds in a sauce bath. I'm getting less creative by the day. That's right, it's the first day. Oh my god, it's pretty good. Even more hardcore. So we got hardcore, casual, male, and hardcore appeal. Yeah. This should make us some passive money again. And now, do we do a single right now, or do we wait for the new idols? I guess we can wait for the new idols, right? It's only gonna be a few more days. Is this lost time? I can't tell. Shall we build a theater? Increase your income by upgrading the theater to enable streaming and sell subscriptions to your fans. Oh, that sounds like I'm absolutely milking them, which will be good money-wise. Costs us 20 million, though. That's a lot, and 150,000 a week. I wonder if it, like, pays itself off or not. Let's do something while we wait. Let's get a theater. What can we do here? Oh my good lord. Alright, okay. Casual fans are not very interested in Manzai. All idols of little abnormalities gain experience in funny and smart skills for each Manzai performance. Performance is equally appealing to all fans. And day off. Let's take the day off on Thursday and Tuesday, because I can't have them working like every day, right? That's not gonna be good. Ticket price wise, let's go up to 4,000. I don't know if the game like sets the right ticket price from the start. Like with the concert, it wasn't the case, so we can purchase some more equipment, which is very expensive. We need to research streaming for this theater and purchase necessary equipment for streaming. Your fans can subscribe to your streaming service and watch performances for a monthly fee. We'll gain or lose subscribers every day. It's just like YouTube. Fans decide whether they want to subscribe or not based on the last 30 days. Main factors that affect this are subscription price. Hardcore fans are easier to get than casual fans. Adult fans are easier to get than teens. Casual fans are not interested in Manzai. What is a Manzai? I might need to Google this one. Number of days off in a month. You're getting subscribers by selling the service to your existing fans. You can't have more subscribers than fans, but increasing your number of fans will get you more subscribers. Okay. I have no subscribers yet. Will people just appear in here to, like, watch the girls perform? Is that how it works now? I'm curious. Oh yeah! Matsumura Oren is singing for just about 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 people or something. And now, is this a Manzai? Is a Manzai like a funny routine or something? Okay, Brady. What a cool girl. I guess Hatanaka Manami is somewhat cool. Here we go. Let's play the idol gacha! Okay. Ebisawa Sumire. Beautiful looking hair. I really like it. Her voice is pretty good. Training sessions are 30% faster. She's a prodigy. Saito Karen. Is that a silver idol, I guess? Perfectionist. Takes a hit to mental stamina when an event they participated in goes poorly. That's alright, look at her. She has very high, skill ceilings. She has a lot to learn when it comes to dancing. The potential is very high. Okay, who else? Here's my gold idol. 15 years old. Horinoichi Hinano. Stat bonus when hosting a show alone. We might have to give her a show immediately then. Yamauchi Ruka. Oh god, judging by her picture, you would think she's really cute, but apparently she isn't. Events that would damage relationships hurt less. She's loyal. And Sato Aoi, 12. And she's just about the cutest thing you can ever imagine in your life. So we're gonna hire her. I'm gonna hire. I'm tempted to hire them all, actually. She has a 2x bonus to photoshoot payments. Holy fucking moly. Imagine getting paid twice as much for a cute photoshoot with her. Well, I'm gonna get them all. Gotta get them all. Do I hold another one, I wonder? Hey, I'm part of Little Abnormalities now. I'm not sure, maybe I'll make a new group. I'm glad to hear you're looking out for me and the other girls, but just between you and me, I think I'll be fine on my own. She's the lone wolf?
Are it?
Wow, you really chose to accept me? Oh my god, look at the bloomers. I'm surprised, I made a bunch of mistakes during the audition. I mean, I'm happy to be here. I just thought that we all make little mistakes. Now, please raise your arms. Hey, glad to see you in person. I'm sure you've seen my photos, right? Don't they just look... What? Exactly? Winsome in them? Ah, she's the 12-year-old Sumo. Of course she's gonna make up some new words. I can't talk this young speak. Hey, I'm Ebisawa Sumire. Everyone says I'm a fast learner. I'll be sure to do my best. Good. Oh, her voice. Good to be here. I hear showbiz can get pretty rough and tumble, but I bet it's easier to survive if you have friends. And also the skills to pay the bills.
Yo.
Hey, I hope you don't mind me stopping by. Of course you do. I just hired new idols. I heard you recently had another round of auditions, and I thought I'd check in to see how things are going. It seems like you keep adding new faces to Little Abnormalities. Considering how the roster seems to be growing, have you considered starting another group? A second group? Oh, to be clear, I'm not suggesting that you abandon Little Abnormalities to start some competing group. I'm just talking about creating a sister group. You know, a second group of idols that operates under the Little Abnormalities banner. A subgroup, so to speak. Why would I want to do that? Can you tell me about the benefits, actually, if you want to? Well, you've got a lot of idols and you probably want to put those idols to work doing things like working on new singles. But if you put out new singles too often, audience can start to feel fatigued. Oh, so I can work two groups in tandem. That is actually... I guess this is how you make money. It's taken me, what, 35 episodes to find this out? Let's put it this way, if Little Abnormalities puts out two singles in a month, people will start to get tired of the non-stop releases. But if you create a second group, and then release one single under each group's name, it helps to break up the monotony a little bit. Of course, any sister group you create will be subsidiary of Little Abnormalities. Little Abnormalities will still be the main group, so idols that are part of the sister group will still be able to participate in Little Abnormalities activities. Anyway, just something to think about. Might also be worth considering the impact that splitting idols into multiple groups will have on social dynamics. Idols can still be friends in different groups, but they'll probably be spending enough time apart that they won't form cliques with members of other groups. Is that a good or a bad thing? Of course, it can be a good thing too. If you have problems with bullying in a group, sometimes the best solution is to separate the bully and the victim. And putting them in different groups is one way to achieve that. Just something to think about. I'm not really a fan of thinking. I don't know if you noticed. Anyway, like I said, I don't mean to put pressure on you if you're not ready. It's a lot to think about. Yes, I guess. But if you start looking at the Little Abnormalities roster and think that you have too much talent to fit into one group, consider making a sister group. You should be able to find the option to do that by looking at the idol roster on the main menu. Alright, let's pause. We're gonna hold in... Oh my god, I lost so much money already. I shouldn't have gotten the... Look at this dress. Oh, she's already going to work. I guess that's a silver idol for you. Or was she the gold one? I can't remember. Like, there's too many names now. It's gonna get very hard for me to remember anything. So we now have the Little Abnormalities. And maybe we can form a subgroup. Because I don't think Hatanaka Manami should work with another gold idol. I think Horinoichi Hinano should spearhead her own group. And who are we gonna, like, what are we gonna call them, though? We have the Little Abnormalities, and what else? The cute tools? No, I guess the tools were abnormalities, too. Like, the Sephira? But we started releasing the Sephira as singles, right? Oh, of course, I know what we're gonna call them. The Librarians. Select your target all. I can select my target. Could I do this before? My target audience? Of course, it's gonna be the hardcore adult males, right? I don't know! Can I not change this over time? Mr. Delta, I've been meaning to talk to you about the librarians. Great choice of name, by the way. Thank you very much, Nishikawa Kiyoka. It's no Little Abnormalities. Classics can be tough to beat, but I'm sure the public will learn to love the librarians. I've already handled all the standard paperwork, you know, registering trademarks for the new group name, those sorts of things. No need for you to worry about any of that. So you mean I don't have to work anything? That's nice. As for the actual business decisions around the Little Abnormalities members, or which Little Abnormalities members should be transferred to the librarians, I'll leave that in your capable hands. You can do that from the idle roster on the main menu. All you have to do is click on an idol's card and select group to choose which group to assign it to. One thing to note is that the librarians will have its own progression that's different from Little Abnormalities. Sister groups work a bit differently from what you might be used to. I like how they're giving you two tutorials for this. You want me to tell you a bit more about that? Tell me all about it, actually, before I make any more mistakes in this. Alright. Sister groups like the librarians gain fans whenever releasing a new single. If you look at the menu for the librarians, it should break down all the numbers for you. Sister groups like individual idols have parameters like cool, sexy, funny, and so on. Releasing singles will not only gain new fans based on the sister group's demographic appeal, but it will also give progress towards increasing the sister group's parameters based on which idols participated in that single. If you want to make your sister group more cute, you should pick out some cute idols and have theme release a single. The same goes for any other attribute, of course. Whenever a sister group increases its attribute, you get a point towards appeal with a specific demographic of your choice. If your sister group becomes more pretty, you might decide to increase the group's appeal with hardcore fans or female and so on. What do hardcore fans want exactly? Can you tell me that? Increasing your appeal with those demographics will in turn increase the number of fans you get the next time that the librarians release a single. Whew, that was a mouthful. That's what she said. I think I might be overcomplicating things a little. I'm sure you'll figure it out once you start experimenting with things. Maybe I'll have someone nice on YouTube tell me how it works. To put it briefly, having the librarians release new singles is the key to improving the librarians. Every single not only gives you more fans, but also increases the group's stats, which in turn will allow you to recruit even more fans for future singles. And don't forget to choose which demographics you want to increase your appeal with every time one of the librarians' parameters levels up. If you ever get confused, just find a green help icon on the librarians' menu. That should clear things up. Have you decided which idols from Little Abnormalities should transfer over and be part of the newly formed the librarians? I'm not sure who to pick. Can you give me in that case, allow me to offer my own suggestion. One thing to consider is that Little Abnormalities fans follow individual idols, so if you transfer Little Abnormalities idol to the librarians, all of the fans will follow them. Maybe Matsumura Oren or something. We'll switch over. If you're looking to kickstart the librarians and start things off with a bang, it might be worth assigning some of the more famous idols to the new group. Just something to think about. I mean, she's like a second generation Little Abnormality, but still. Also, idols who are part of groups can still appear in singles for the main group, but not the other way around. So if you're releasing a Little Abnormalities single, idols from either Little Abnormalities or the librarians can participate. But if you're releasing a librarian single, only the librarian's idols can participate. Keep that in mind as you think about who to transfer. Of course, the librarians is a subsidiary of Little Abnormalities in a lot of ways. It might be easier to think of everyone as just belonging to the same big organization. I'll still be working with the librarians as well as Little Abnormalities, and so will all of the other staffers. Single releases are the main place where the two groups are going to differ. I say two groups, but who knows, maybe this is just the start of a perpetually expanding dynasty. But let's not get too ahead of ourselves. I'm looking forward to see which idols get chosen to be part of the librarians. Okay, the game is paused. Click an idol's card and select group to assign it to a different group. Cooldown on transferring idols is 1 year. Okay, the new ones. And... do I want Tanaka Sara? No, it can't be like a leader type girl. It can't be like Manami, Sara, or Mayu. Because they are like powerful personalities already. So it's gotta be Matsumura Oren. She's gonna have to place herself under Horinouchi Hinano. And do we keep someone of the new girls? For the actual Little Abnormality main group. It's like five of them in here now, and one, two, 6 of them in Little Abnormalities. I'm tempted to just hold another, like, audition, though. Like a regional one, which is not expensive at all, and it gives you one guaranteed silver idol. And a chance at a gold one, actually. And if we get some stinkers, we can just fire them to get rid of some scandal points? Is that how it works? Maybe I should try this out, actually. But I'm getting attached, you know? That's a... I guess that's not a good thing. Yeah, let's hold another audition. Oh, today's episode will be a fucking mess. Actually, while we do this, we should also think of two new singles, I guess. What do we do? Let's make this like a placeholder thingy. I guess we have I chose male adult hardcore, right? What is the most male adult hardcore we can go for? I believe in a thing called love. Just come and get it in my heart. With a chance we can make it now. When I look into the sun goes down. I believe in a thing called love. Cute? Our cuteness is level 7. That's pretty good. And we have this, and we have two green. Regret cute, and now we need something to like increase our male appeal. This is something like that. No, there's no genre to appeal to males, apparently. There's like R&B appeals to females, but you'd think that metal would appeal more to males, but I don't know. Or rock. There's nothing appealing to males, actually. Let's take a look if we can even things out then. I guess pop? No. No, EDM would be minus adult, which is not a good thing. Metal? Maybe we can level it up still? Is this something... Something we can do here? It's very hard to appeal to the male fantasy, apparently. This. It's the best we can do. Metal regrets sexy. Alright. Let's see if we can level up the metal genre. Metal regrets sexy. Yeah, I'm thinking about my music now a little bit. I'm first going for a theme and then trying to think of a name. Where is it? Metal regrets sexy. We've got unlocking side here. Okay, finally. Regret. It's gonna get leveled up. Here we go. Do we want to level up anything here? No. Not anything we can do really here. I guess this could also help us. But let's not for now. Get this to level 3 at least, please. Thank you. Okay. That was sexy regret and metal. Yeah, it looks fine. There's like 3 greens here. It's gonna be a digital only release because we're gonna need to test the waters for the librarian's debut single, I guess that's what it's called. And what do we want for this? What is pretty metal? And what did we... What's pretty metal? Regretful and sexy. I can fit two of these if I go for the Forsaken Murderer, because I think Metal and Regret fit the Forsaken Murderer. Could have the Bloodbath? What else do we have? I mean, a lot of these Abnormality titles, they sound pretty fucking metal if you like imagine them being on like a Metal Group's album or something. Except for maybe Rudolta. You know what? Because it's such a beautiful title, actually. Funeral of the... I can't type. Dead Butterflies. Yeah. And we're gonna go for the...
Yatta! Yatta!
Yatta!
Yatta! Producer-san, ureshii! Yatta!
Yeah, we can go for like one more girl per group or something. I mean, what is the max? Like, 5 plus 4 is 9, plus 3 is 12, plus 2 is 14, plus 1 is 15. So let's see, what appeals to the hardcore male audience? Cute. Lots of cute and cute girls. Cute girls. Maybe I should put Abe Miki in here as well. So she can... They can participate still. They can participate still. Cute and sexy is what I want. Hardcore male. Hardcore male. Cute and sexy girls. So do they want all of them to participate? For this one? Yeah, I know you're unhappy with this. Oh my god, stupid bitch. Hata Nakamanami, no. No, you know what? No. Maybe her, because she's entirely new as well. I don't know if this, like, how this works, if this is a good thing or not, really. And we're gonna create a new one again as well, immediately, which is gonna be for the main group, like the little abnormalities. And what else do we want to do here? I don't know what our appeal there is, really. Like, let's see what we go for. If we go for like the highest level we have in each category, just cute, loneliness, rock, no, avant-garde. That's a huge hardcore appeal, like really fucking big. Avant-garde, cute, loneliness. I think we've done Letizia already, didn't we? What else is pretty? Pretty lonely and cute. Or maybe the little prince. I mean, the story of the little prince is cute. Not really lonely, it's more like about friends, I guess. And a little bit about happiness. Is there anything else we can go for, actually? No, let's go for like the little prince. We're gonna make another digital only release because we need the money, okay? We need the money. I know. Or shall we go for an individual handshake event? How expensive would that be if we go for like 45,000 to produce? 10 million is okay, isn't it? I'm not sure I'll have that. But we'll try. Okay. And now,
yes!
How do I? Did I release this other one under the? Oh my god! I released it under Little Abnormalities, didn't I? Can I still change it? That's why I could choose everyone. Oh, this game is game can be fucking confusing at times. It's just it's a thing I need to get used to. Okay, the team chemistry in this is already like way high, I guess because they've worked together before. Okay, we're gonna change the formation on the funeral. Here we go, the librarians. So with the librarians, just they can participate. But that's okay, I mean the stats are good enough, I would say. Now I should take care though, who to place where. We want cute... And, sexiness? Pretty, like, the highest stats up front, basically. Question is, what is better? We switch these two. That's like... 50-56? 50-30-56? Yes! The cute stats change, but overall... Oh, here we go. I can take a look at that. 63, 66, 85.
Yes! Yes!
6386. This is slightly better, I guess?
Yes!
Yeah, okay, I'm gonna keep it like that then. Good, okay, now we have like one for the librarians, one for the abnormalities. You can see it like that. And we can start producing stuff. Oh, this one's already being done here. Okay, and finally there's something, like there's work to do for my office workers and stuff. I should have done this ages ago. And I'm having a new addition already. Good, this is good, this is good, this is good. I like this. And we should mostly, I severely forgot about this. We should do some of that. However, like since so many others are on low stamina, I don't really want them to work right now. How can I let them recover more stamina? That's like always a problem, it seems like. Maybe it will get better with more of them now. What is that? Oh, okay. Wow, alright. Why can I not do that for the main group, I wonder? They already have fans. Like, they have hardcore adult fans. Male and female, I guess, due to what's more Orin being in there. Okay. Yeah, well. Good. The new girls are already, like, working with the slightly older girls. I guess Abimiki has not been with us for that long. Of course, now, the thing is, I have more bad girls now as well, so they're gonna appear in the selection of girls, but, well, as long as they have stamina, I can send them on jobs, why not? Losen is looking for a funny girl. Make that 60,000 and we're in agreement. Good. It also will take me a while to get used to the new personalities and stuff now, I guess. Alright. We're gonna hold this audition and then, I don't know, will we release a single today? We're gonna take a look. Kitano Reno, she looks like a Christmas tree. Paranoid. Miyazaki Ayami, oh my god, she's... I love that. I love the hair. I don't know why, but... Oof. Very high potential for vocal and sexy. A trendy girl. Ishimori Suzuka, she's 12. Is that the youngest we've had so far? I think Satomaya started out like as 12-year-old too. She's cute and can get pretty. So, bonus appeal with teen and young adult fans, less appeal with adult fans. Oh, that's not a good thing for us. Goto Seira? Wow, I like the color scheme. Penalty to dance, bonus to comedy. So she's funny, or what does this mean exactly? Dance and funny stats are almost the same. And, oh my god, two silver girls, we got lucky! I hit the gacha. Maternal, gets along better with younger girls. Damn, she doesn't look like 17. We're gonna hire her. I think we're gonna hire all of them except for the Christmas tree, because she was paranoid. And even though, like, she had some good potential, the others were just straight up better. And this is gonna be my new favorite girl, Miyazaki. Let's finish. The girls here all work so hard, don't they? I'm so proud to be accepted as part of Little Abnormalities. Whoops, sorry about that. Didn't notice a step leading into your office. It's clumsy.
Saika!
Yo, this place is popping! Oh yeah, it will be in a while. Wait, how old are you again? I'm super stoked to be here. Good to be here. I hear showbiz can get pretty rough and tumble. Yep, with me it can. Actually, I think I've been recording... If my recording time is right, I've been recording for about 40 minutes, so I should stop soon. Which means... We're not gonna see the fruit of our labor today in this episode, but I'm confident. I'm really, really confident now. I'm gonna end the recording here. I'm gonna shuffle around some idols, like off recording, basically, like off video. And next time we're gonna release the two singles. Maybe I can even change something about the formation still. I will do so as well. And yeah, next week everything's gonna be better. Like, we're gonna be more successful. I feel it in my bones. Like, my funny bone is tingling. And that's always a good sign when there's something tingling in my pants. And looking at these girls, it just keeps happening. So, bye everyone.